FM radio 93.7, and also live streaming via our parish Facebook page. We're about to begin the celebration of the 29th of the 11 a.m. Mass for the 29th Sunday of Ordinary Time. A reminder to anyone who may be praying with us from the parking lot, at communion time, the minister will come out to the covered walkway to distribute communion to anyone praying with us from the parking lot. At that time, please come forward to receive communion, then kindly return to your vehicle for the remainder of this celebration. For any unable to come forward, once those who are able have done so, then please drive up to the covered walkway, and a minister will bring communion to you while you are in your vehicle. Again, then simply return to your spot in the parking lot for the remainder of this celebration. Thank you, and we will begin shortly. Again, good morning, everyone, and welcome. Please stand and let's sing together our entrance chant, 10,000 Reasons, Bless the Lord. To you I call, for you will surely heed me. O God, turn your ear to me. Hear my words, guard me as the apple of your eye. In the shadow of your wings, protect me.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we gather with one another in the presence of God, let us pause and call to mind our sins as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you come to us in word and in sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord was pleased to crush him in infirmity. If he gives his life as an offering for sin, he shall see his descendants in a long life, and the will of the Lord shall be accomplished through him. Because of his affliction, he shall see the light of fullness of days. Through his suffering, my servant shall justify many, and their guilt he shall bear. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
They became indignant must make their authority over them felt. But it shall not be simple among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you will be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first among you will be the slave of all. For the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for men. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's not unusual for many individuals to want to be associated with someone who perhaps is very popular, well-loved, admired, respected, in charge, and the list goes on. To be associated with such an individual offers that unique opportunity where perhaps our popularity might increase. We get to meet and associate with others that perhaps we wouldn't have the opportunity to do so if it weren't for our connection, our association with this central personality. So I wonder, is that what's behind the question that James and John posed to Jesus? Were they caught up by how popular and to some degree influential Jesus appeared to be with others, and wanted to be in a position to him in such a way that if any of that popularity, if you will, if any of that respect or authority or anything else would overflow, they would be close enough to at least catch some of it. Of course, the truth is that we really can't know this from the scriptures. We can't know what their motivation was behind this request to sit at his right or at his left when he came into his glory. But we do know, and we're reminded time and again, that Jesus never saw himself as that kind of leader. At least up to this point in the gospel accounts of his life. Jesus was never depending on a second or a third in command. He never saw himself as the one to be served, but rather as the one who would not only serve, but also would be the one who would clearly model just what service in God's kingdom was to look like. Just how service in God's kingdom was to be lived out, how service in God's kingdom was to be a manifestation of belief, a manifestation of faith, was to be the flesh and the blood, if you will, of discipleship. Whoever wishes to be great among you will be your servant. Who wishes to be first will be the slave of all. For the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many. While it was James and John that got this particular conversation going with their question, it was Jesus who was as clear as he could be and elevated that conversation by letting them and letting others know that not only does the path that he was taking, but the path that they would take be a manifestation of this type of service and sacrifice. And for that matter, all who choose to become and follow as disciples would, yes, perhaps include some suffering, even death. But first and foremost, they would be called to a life lived in service. Again, whoever wishes to be great among you will be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first will be the slave of all. My friends, there's no better person than you and I and others can associate ourselves with, connect ourselves with, no better person than Jesus Christ. And it's not because we will then be well positioned, if you will, in such a way as to catch whatever portion of his popularity or admiration or love or respect might overflow. Rather, it will be in our living out our call to serve in his name where his strength and his presence will be made known. His strength and presence being made known and become real for others. And then, God's kingdom will continue to grow.
Church, the people of God, may always bear witness in the world to the self-sacrificing love of Christ Jesus. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The leaders of nations may recall the source of their power and govern justly, with dignity and respect, those who are called to serve, protecting and safeguarding all life, from conception until natural death. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who suffer from emotional pain or physical illness, especially Bob Breyer, Donna Bueller, Danny Firth, Floss Firth, Doug Fox, Dacia Firthby, Dave Gilbride, June Christmer, Julianne Jenkins, Deborah Kelly, Greta Kuckermeyer, Tom Markowski, Bernie Boziowski, Willie Naso, Francis O'Leary, Mary Ann Oliver, Chloe Pasco, Lena Ulezize, Ann Richardson, Vivian Richardson, George Zerba R. Jr., Courtney Shipp, J.P. Zeller, along with the victims and survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church, may find strength in Christ, the suffering servant of all. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may respond to the Lord, who calls each of us to evangelize and go out as missionaries to bring good news to all. ministries exercised in Christ's name may prosper and flourish in praise of God and to the good of others. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may open the hearts and minds of each and every one of us so that we might follow where God leads us. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have recently died, Beth and Cottrell, along with all the dead who held fast to their confession of faith on earth, may pass through the heavens to stand with joy before the throne of grace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may offer to God with confidence the hopes and needs that remain in our hearts and minds, along with those written in our prayer notes book, as well as those we have been asked to pray for, trusting God will answer. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Maker and author of life, in Jesus, we have found the path to wisdom. Let us therefore be bold to approach Him, not seeking privilege, but asking mercy. Let us live among one another, not seeking to be served, but to serve. Through Jesus, who is not ashamed to call us brothers and sisters, a high priest who sympathizes with our weakness and interceded on our behalf. Christ Jesus, who is one with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory chant, we've sing together in the summons, and it's number 387. Verse 5.
Lord,
that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory."
The mystery of faith.
chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you help us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church. Spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him,
thank you.
behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy
that ye should enter under my roof,
but only say the word,
and my soul shall be healed.
The Son of Man has come to give his life as a ransom for the many. Our communion chant, let's sing together One Love Released, and it's number 333.
Oh,
gifts that are eternal. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Always thanking you, and so many will give up their time and their talent that supports your parishes and your ministry, and again, the treasure is so important as well. Humble users, do remember collection boxes and connections to the church. Don't forget your bulletins. There's a couple key inserts in there again this weekend. And take 500 entrances of the church. Just a few reminders. Next Sunday, following this Mass, we will have an 80th anniversary, another grab and go event to prepare lunches for Open Head Ministries, who have just been so grateful for the effort from this community and so many others as well. I always remind you, if you not yet participated, bite the bullet. Join with others. It's less than 45 minutes. Over 100 lunches are prepared. It's a lot of fun. It's all sizes, shapes, and ages of individuals who come together, families come together. It's just a great, great thing, and we do great things as a result of it. So thank you for your consideration. We do are in need of cookies to put in the lunches, and those can be dropped off in the Fairview Hall kitchen next weekend. Please do so. Make sure you do so before the 11 a.m. Mass at the latest. There's an insert on helping hands in the bulletin this weekend for those who may need assistance with leaf raking, fall cleanup in their gardens, etc. Please get that filled out, get that turned in as soon as possible. We thank those who come together to do precisely that, to help with their hands. We've repeated the insert on the 80th anniversary memories and pictures that we're asking for. Memories and pictures have been coming in. Thank you very much. But as a reminder, we're open and need many. Please feel free to reach out to your neighbors and others, especially those who are less mobile and have shut-ins, and get sit with them. Get them and get them into us. I believe the deadline is the end of this month, so that we can get things processed and get them out and ready for the 80th anniversary banquet. So again, please do so soon as possible. And for those of you who are into fires, we will have a big bonfire, a huge bonfire, following the 7 p.m. Mass on All Saints Night, November 1st. I believe it's going to be over in that area. And there will be fire, of course, we're providing the fuel. There will be fun, there will be some music, and there will be light refreshments for all folks. So again, mark that on your calendar. I believe there's an insert on that this weekend. I know that you, along with me, for different reasons, but you're anxious about cool on the ground. I'm anxious to announce it. We have consistently left voicemail messages on one of the winners' phones and not heard back from them. So we have emailed them and not heard back from them. And the next thing will be a certified mail letter and we hope to get some resolution so that we can announce all of them. But that's that all. And there's also been a trip to my house, but no one was home. So anyhow, we're working on it, and then as soon as we can get it all tied up, you'll know, and I'll be happy, and I can put it back in my hand. So there you go. We're also grateful for all who have completed their renewal recommitment cards. Thank you very much. If you've not done that, so please do so today if possible or as soon as possible. The baskets are the intentions of the church for Catholic postures, and there's more information on cards if you have lost it so that you can complete it and fill it out. Once again, thank you. Thank you also to many who have offered one-time gifts. So we are greatly appreciative of all that. Don't forget the Ladies Guild Christmas Bazaar is coming. In addition to many, many fine gift baskets, thank you to those who are donating those. There will be excellent baked goods, there will be wonderful vendors, and there will be great food as always. And this year, the Matus Christmas Warehouse is being emptied out, and a variety of items will be available to choose from, many of which will be handcrafted items. It's stuff that just isn't going to go south. So in January, so it'll be up for grabs. Next Saturday, Saturday evening, before the practicum mass, a rosary will be prayed, so we were there. And also, it's almost time for the banquet. That the banquet will be kind of like the mass will be the closure, the banquet will be the fun part. That's December 7th. We're going to start opening up the sale of tickets for that, and that will be next weekend. But we do need help in selling those following after all the masses. So there are sign up seats in the front vestibule. If you would be so kind as to consider, you know, just one weekend, one mass time, more the merrier, to help sell those, we would be grateful. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Let's sing Go Into the World, and it's number 380.